Hi, I'm Fraser Douglas, the avid tent camper. In this video, I want to tell you about a new product that I've developed that helps us to organize our kitchen much more efficiently. Lalo, what's the name of this new product?
Top Shelf.
Say it loud.
Top Shelf.
Top Shelf, that's right. If you've watched many of my videos, you know that I like to use milk crates to pack my kitchen equipment.
We typically pack our kitchen gear into two milk crates. In one milk crate, we nest our plates, our bowls, our cooking pots, frying pan, and serving platters. And in the second milk crate, we pack our eating utensils, cooking utensils, cups, and other small items. Furthermore, we pack our food in two more milk crates, which always stay in the back of our car. We like these milk crates because they pack easily in the back of the car, and because when we get to the campsite, we can turn them on their side to make kitchen storage cabinets.
Now, they work fine like this, and if I want to put something large and heavy, like a frying pan on top, that works fine too. But if, hand me that salt shaker there. Yeah, thank you. But if I want to put small items like this little plastic salt shaker up here, it could very easily get tipped and knocked off to the side. And so I thought, wouldn't it be nice to be able to put a shelf up here where I could put a lot of small items and put my heavy items down below.
Before showing you the shelf, let me give you a little bit of background. I've been impressed with the efficiency of a chuck wagon for many years. Although they carried all of the camping equipment, food and cooking supplies for about a dozen cowboys or more, they were organized so that they could start cooking meals within minutes after arriving at their new campsite. All they had to do was start a campfire, drop the back door of their cupboard to make a table, and pull out their potatoes, beans, meat, and desserts, and start peeling potatoes and mixing ingredients. Within an hour or two, they would have a great hot meal. When recreational camping became popular in the early 1900s, a few families used trailers to continue this tradition. But trailers created extra problems when camping, and cars got large enough to haul all of the camping supplies, kitchen supplies, and food for a family camping trip. With this chuck wagon tradition in mind, and I have packed my food and cooking supplies at the back of my car for several years, and I have continued to look for better ways to organize these materials so that I can begin cooking a meal immediately when I pull up to a campsite. I've looked at several chuck boxes posted on the web, but I can't see how any of them would improve my efficiency. They all apparently must be removed from the back of the car and set up somewhere in the campsite. Now that requires extra time, extra effort, and probably an extra person to help carry the heavy box over to a picnic table. And none of them include the ice cooler or any food items. And so I settled on the two milk crate idea instead. At first, I would move the picnic table up under my tarp and then set up one milk crate on each bench. But eventually, I got tired of trying to drag heavy picnic tables all over the campsite. Then I made my own 5-foot-long table to hold my kitchen supplies, but it was a little too big to pack efficiently. So now we use a 4-foot-long table and try to set it up as close to the car as possible so that we don't have to carry our kitchen gear very far. Now,
let me just show you how we made this top shelf. I started out with a piece of 1/4 inch plywood and cut it about 28 inches long and 12 inches wide. And then I screwed a piece of 1x2 on each side. Here's one here and another one over there. Point to that one. Point to this one. That one over there. Okay. And one at the back. This is the top of the top shelf. Now let's turn it over. The bottom is exactly the same. 1x2 on each side, but this time the 1x2 is at the front of the shelf. So when we put it up on our milk crates, it only goes that far back and no further back. You can slide it forward. Watch your fingers. But it stops right there. And now we've got edge all the way around the sides and the back. So when we put our salt shaker up there, we don't have to worry about it getting tipped off to the side.
On an earlier version of the top shelf, we put the border all the way around both sides, front and back, but realized that this design was not efficient. In the early stages of my thinking, I thought that I could stack all 4 milk crates in the back of my car, but as soon as you drive to the store, everything goes flying. In fact, even when you put 2 milk crates on their side, all the stuff will come out as soon as you try to drive anywhere. And so we just leave our food in the back of the car in the upright crates. When our kitchen is completely set up, you'll notice that our milk crates are on a table closest to the car, our stove is on a second table, and our seating and eating area is at the back of the tarp. Here's what it looks like in our recent camp to Topsail State Park in Florida.
Remember, take more trips, travel further, visit more attractions, and save money.
Go tent camping.